Hello, my name is Eloy Rodriguez. I'm the broker for Ridgecrest Realty in Ridgecrest, California, and I'm here to explain to anybody who cares to learn that what is a deed of trust, and how is a deed of trust different than a mortgage. So I find that in my business that many, even agents, don't know what a deed of trust is, and still don't after years. So here then is a definitive lecture on how to understand what a deed of trust is and how it compares to a mortgage. Okay, so I have a little graphics here that I drew up. You can tell it's very sophisticated. But anyhow, I'm going to start with this cow example. The cow is not real property, it's personal property, but it shows the process that one goes when a contract is broken with regards to personal property. So in this case, A has sold the cow to B, or we could say that A lent money to B to buy this cow. It could be his cow or not. If it was his cow, it would be seller financing. If not, he just provided the financing. What happens is that B gives a promissory note known as an IOU to A, and now he has the funds to buy the cow, or he's given the cow. But now we have a question that arises. What happens if B starts to be a jerk, let's say for one reason or another, and he just flips off A and says, you know what, forget it, I'm just not going to pay you. So you're not supposed to go as A into B's yard and go lasso that cow and take him out of there. You're going to get shot, or you could be for trespassing. So that's not how it's done. You can't go back and get your property or your collateral in this case. So you have to go to court. You have to go through there and get a judgment. If the judgment you're in your favor, now it's up to you to do something with that judgment. It's not over. So you have to either try to find his bank account or her bank account, figure out if there's any money in it, and use this to go to the bank to go and take that seller that money in there. I put garnish. It's supposed to. Oh no, that's garnish. Garnish. Yeah. Okay. So garnish. You can garnish the salary. Going to the employer and say, look, here is the judgment and you have to send so much money to me whatsoever. And if they have a car or some other asset, including the cow, you can force a sheriff's sale to sell that, and then those monies, proceeds, would come back to you. Now, the problem is, if you get somebody who has, what they say, a turnip, you can't squeeze blood out of a turnip. If they don't have it, the judgment is not a criminal charge against the debtor. It's a civil case, so this is trying to find monies to convert and pay you off via this judgment. So you can see it can be tedious. Okay, so now let's talk about, instead of the cow, we put the horse, and we're talking about the deed of trust. Okay, so now, instead of the cow, we have a house, and A lends the money to B, right? B buys it. Now there are two things here. Now you have your IOU, but you have this thing called a deed of trust. Okay, that deed of trust is what it says the following, that if you don't pay me, I can foreclose right away, as soon as I want, as soon as you're late. And that foreclosure has this house as collateral. And it goes beyond that, because once you have the deed of trust, there's this trustee that's actually holding an actual, what they call naked title. That's how they technically get around it. But the bottom line is that you don't have to go to court. If you don't go to court, you don't have a judgment, but you have a statutorial way, without going to court, of being able to try to collect your funds that you lended, and it's called a foreclosure. And the foreclosure in California is like 90 days. You have to post a notice that's recorded in the county recorder, and it says 90 days. You have 90 days, or there's going to be an auction coming. And then after the 90 days, there are 22 days. And up until when the trustee holds a sale. Now, that sale has to be a public, so a trustee sale is the same as a public auction. And they can either be on the courtyard stairs of the courtyard, or it can be an online auction. There are different venues, but the bottom line is that this auction is cash only. And let me say here, on the 22nd day, If the debtor goes up to the 17th day, that's it. They can't even make it good if they wanted to. It's going to go to auction. So it goes to auction, right? And these guys are all, and girls or guys are making bids. And this is the auctioneer. And he's doing it as part of an action under the trustee who's holding a trustee sale. And so there's outcomes that can happen. So first of all, the actual cash, the most that the lender can actually get out of it is what's owed him. So it would be the balance owed on the loan plus any late fees, plus any accrued penalties, plus the actual cost of doing the foreclosure. The foreclosure itself, and there's many businesses that do it for you. It's not very expensive, but they take care of all the timing and the paperwork necessary to go through the statutory process. So then what happens? Oh, okay. So let's say somebody did bid. Well, that bidder becomes not a no owner, but a new owner. And over here, there's no accepted offer. Well, look what happens. When there's no accepted offer, then at that point, the lender, A, becomes the new owner. Or he receives a trustee deed. A trustee deed. Now, let me explain, clear something up right now. There's something called a grant deed, and it has nothing whatsoever to do with trust deed. And that's been the most confusing of all, because you see a trustee's deed, and then you hear the word grant deed. Grant deed, quitclaim deed, warranty deed, trustee deed, tax deed, all of those are conveyances of one person's rights to a property conveyed to another. They're really, grant deed is a title, and it shows who granted the deed to the new buyers. So is a quitclaim. So is a warranty. All of these are ways of conveying, but they have nothing to do at all with trust, deed of trust. The deed of trust is like a mortgage, right? Except that you don't have to go to court. So it's all really in favor of the lender. So now what happens is the lender receives a trustee deed, and that if that lender is a owner, is a institutional bank, they call that asset an REO. That's real estate owned by the bank. So when you see REO, that means it's already gone through the foreclosure process, and now the bank owns it. Ridgecrest Realty often gets calls from the bank, and they said, we have these REOs, and we'd like you to sell them on the market. First, I do a study of what I think it's worth. Then they get an independent appraisal, and between the two, they'll tell me, all right, listed at such and such price, and I put that REO out there for sale. Those are the ones that you see in the bank-owned properties. That's because they own them now. It went through the process. So in that case, if A could be the owner of the house, but he gave the title over, but the trustee kept the naked title, but he gave grant deed to the new owners, but there's a deed of trust. So now this is called seller financing, because the guy sold him the house and provided the financing. So in this case, if it's the owner and it forecloses, then the owner gets title back and he can sell the house again. If not, the lender, if you're just a lender, the lender ends up being the new owner. The mortgage route. You see, it's going to be a lot like cow route. A lends money to B to buy the house, right? There is a promissory note, and now, notice instead of a deed of trust, we have a mortgage. Very similar. The only difference is that with the mortgage, you have to go to court to foreclose. And it takes time and expensive, and you get finally a judgment of foreclosure. And now, after all of that, and believe me, there's rights of redemption. So even after the foreclosure takes place, there could be a right of redemption for the original owner of the property to make good his debt. So that means you can't really sell the place until that redemption period is over. So what happens when he wins the judgment? You can have some type of sheriff sale, which in this case, the sheriff sale is a public auction. And this time the public auction is held. It has the same outcome. Now you either have an accepted, no accepted offer. Then A, the lender, or the former owner become the new owner again. And again, if you have an accepted offer, then whoever bid on the auction, they became, yes. So what is the difference between a deed of trust and a mortgage? It's how you go about foreclosing. Do you have to go through court, or do you skip court? That is the difference between them. And a deed of trust and a mortgage are similar, up except for the way one is a statutorial way of foreclosing and one is a judicial. The mortgage must be do judicial and go through the court. The deed of trust bypasses it. All right? That is the moral of the story. All right, thanks.